Hi there, I'm Sean Dillman. In this video, I'll be showing you how to install the Brother iPrint&Scan software on your computer and smartphone. As always, if you like this video, please be sure to click the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. To start the process, go to support.brother.com, click on Product Search, and enter the model number for your machine. In this case, I'll type in HL-L2370DW, and I'll click Search. Now click on Downloads. Your browser will likely detect your operating system and version automatically, but if it doesn't, select the correct ones and then click OK. Next, click where it says Full Driver and Software Package Recommended. By downloading this package, you'll have all of the drivers and software that you need to use your printer. At the next screen, the End User License Agreement, scroll down and click the button which says Agree to the EULA and Download. The software package will now download, and you can right-click on it and click Show in Folder. You'll see it here in your Downloads folder, where you can double-click it to start the install process. At the first screen, I'll select English as my language. I'll next click the box next to where it says, I accept this license agreement, and then I'll click the Next button. At this screen, you'll select Wi-Fi, Ethernet, or USB cable as your connection type. If you watch my review video on the Brother HL-L2370DW laser printer, you'll see that I walk you through the steps of connecting your printer to your Wi-Fi network. Because I'm connecting my printer wirelessly, that's the connection that I'll click, and then I'll click the Next button. At this screen, the software will search for your machine based on the type of connection that you've selected. In my case, the software has detected my HL-L2370DW laser printer, so I'll click on it, and then I'll click the Next button. Next, I'll click where it says Standard Recommended to download and install the full software package. This process will take a few minutes and then lead to the Additional Options screen. At this point, I won't click the button which says Customize, and instead I'll click on Next. If you want to customize your experience, we can do it later in the process. And with that, we're at the end of the installation process. Click on Finish, and your web browser will direct you back to the Brother website, which you can take a look at or close. At this next step, the software will check for updates. This will update the software that you just downloaded, as well as the software that runs on your printer itself. Click on Update, and this will bring up the Brother firmware update tool. Click where it says I accept, and then click Next. Before you do, please note that this process may clear any data that you already have in your machine. Because of this, I recommend that you complete this update process before setting up a new printer, so that you'll know that you don't have any data in its memory. Click on Next, and now you need to enter the machine's password, which can typically be found on a sticker on the back. On my printer, this is where the sticker is located. Once you enter the password and click OK, the software will connect to your printer and update its firmware. At this point, it's very important that you not turn off the power to your computer or printer during this time. Once the update finishes, press the Done button and you'll be at the Brother registration page. If you want to register, you can access the benefits which are listed here. At this point, the Brother utility software will launch and you can click through the buttons on the left. iPrint&Scan, Do More, Tools, Purchase Supplies, and Support. If you find that you're receiving too many software update notifications, click on where it says Software Update Notification. From here, you can choose to receive notifications weekly, monthly, every 3 months, or every 6 months. Or you can turn the notifications off entirely. If you turn the notifications off, I recommend that you return to the software update application every so often and click where it says Check Now. Updates aren't typically critical, but they are designed to make the software and hardware work better, so this may be of some benefit to you. Once I'm done, I can also right-click on the status monitor icon in my toolbar, and then click on status monitor settings, and then options. If you find that you're receiving too many notifications about the status of your machine, you can make different kinds of changes here. At this point, click exit to close the Brother utilities, and click the icon for the Brother iPrint&Scan software. Click the checkbox for the end user license agreement, and then click OK. Next, click the button in the bottom right corner, which says select your machine. The software will take a few moments to search and then provide you with a list of connected devices. Click on your machine and then click where it says OK. The software will confirm which machine you've selected and display which functions are available. In my case, my machine prints and doesn't offer any other functions like scanning or faxing. Click OK and now you can use the software. On the right, I can see that my machine is connected, that it's in sleep mode, and that my toner cartridge is full. This information will come in handy in the future when I want to know how much toner is left in my machine. If I click on this icon which says print, I can access the folders on my computer and select different files to print. Of course, I can also simply print from any of my specific applications. For example, if I want to print from Microsoft Word, I can launch the application, click File, and then click Print. I'll see my Brother printer listed here, and I can print as per usual. Now that I've set up the software on my computer, I'll also show you how to set it up on your smartphone. I'll go into my App Store, type in iPrint&Scan, and select the first search result. Next, I'll click Install and wait a few moments. When I'm asked if I'll allow the software to access photos, media, and files on my smartphone, I'll click Allow. Next, I'll scroll to the bottom of the End User License Agreement and click Yes. This will launch the app, and the first thing I need to do is select my device. I'll click on Select Now and select the first choice, which is to connect to a machine that is connected to my network. The software will search for a few moments and then find my HLL2370DW series printer. I'll click on it and the software will process a bit and then set it as my default machine. The app then directs me to the support website, but I'll close this browser and go back to finish showing you how the app works. As you can see, I have two options, print and machine settings. If I click on print, I have the following options: photo, documents, cloud services, web page, and email. Using these options, I can print photos and documents from my phone, print from cloud services, print a web page, and print from a connected email account. If I go back to the main page and click on machine settings, I can see all of the information about my machine, including how much toner is left, what the toner model is, and other information. Finally, if I return to the main screen and click on the little circle in the top right corner with an eye in it, I can get all kinds of other information about different machine models, support, and my different cloud service accounts. I can also turn notifications from this app on and off. At this point, I'd recommend that you click here where it says Print Service Plugin to install the Brother Print Service Plugin so that the printing will be integrated with your other phone apps. After you click on it, click the button which says Install. Once it's installed, return to the iPrint&Scan home screen and you're all set. Okay, so before I wrap up, if you liked this video, please be sure to click the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If there's anything that you have questions about that I didn't cover in this video, please be sure to comment below and I'll respond to you as soon as I can. So with that, there you have it. That's how you install the Brother iPrint&Scan software on your computer and smartphone. Thanks again for watching. As always, I'm Sean Dillman.